Welcome back. Autodesk had recently introduced a custom install for Revit 2024 as well as Revit 2023 that you can customize any way you want. I'm going to show you how to do that. I will first log into my Autodesk account and then I'll go to Products and Services and then search for the product that you want to install. In this case, it's Revit 2024 or Revit 2023. Either one would work. And when you're there, you want to check to see that you are installing the right product, the version. Use the pull-down menu. Don't click on Install, and then select Custom Install. After you select the Custom Install, Revit will give you several options to download the latest version or a specific version. You want to make sure that you select the down arrow for customizations, extensions, and content, and check every single line item. This is where you really have to check every line item because there's a lot of information here and a lot of content that may make the difference between a 15-minute install versus a 1 hour install. So check this twice. First, I'm going to change the install to my D drive, not my C drive, for the content and the templates. I'm going to uncheck the box for all the content that is not US English content. I'm not going to need the Korean, Chinese, and Russian because I don't speak those languages. Extensions. If you need any of those extensions, you can go ahead and check those boxes. For example, the Insight Deck Preview, Interoperability Tools for Revit, Lighting Analysis, Structure Analysis, Solar Analysis, depending on your discipline, of course. Now, if you make a mistake and install something you don't need, you can always uninstall it later, so it's not a big deal. Also, you want to check the box for the US English content as well. We go back to the top of the list, double check everything, make sure that you have everything you need, right? As we have said before, all the IES files, libraries, templates, family templates, lookup tables are all installed on my D drive. I have to agree to the terms of use, but also I have to give a name to the package. This will be downloaded as a package, so I'm going to call this the Revit 2024 pack or package and go ahead and download that. I like this a lot. This is something that is we've been awaiting for this type of ease of use for a long time, so thank you, Autodesk, for making this happen. I will download this to my downloads folder. And I'm going to say to Revit, don't, I'm not interested in this survey for now. Okay. I'm going to go to that folder and activate the package or simply double click on the exe file to start. And it will start the installer for you. Right, and of course I have I'm moving here at a faster pace than actual. It takes much a little bit longer than this. Takes about 10 to 15 minutes to download the installer, and once that is done, then you can go ahead and proceed to install the product. And it's a pretty painless process. I find it very useful. And the last step is to click on the install button. Now, after you have installed Revit 2024 or 2023, you want to, of course, launch the software and make sure it actually works. Make sure that all the content and libraries and stuff like that is located in the appropriate folder. So I'm going to show you that in the next video. If you enjoyed this video, and find it informative, please subscribe to this channel and leave a comment below about any topics that you would like us to cover in the future. Thank you.